I'm going to show you my technique for creating and animating gradients like this in After Effects. To start, I've got a color palette to reference and an otherwise empty comp. So first, let's create a new solid with Control Y. The color doesn't matter for now, but let's call it gradient yellow because we always label our layers. And I'm going to add a fill effect to that layer. And let's move that below our palette. I'm adding a fill effect just so it's easier to change the color. We can simply click our eyedrop and select our color, and that changes color in just the fewest clicks that I've found. And then we select our pen tool from up here and draw a mask around an area of our shape. If you're doing this on a shape layer, make sure Tool Creates Mask is selected up here so you don't accidentally draw another shape. Now let's press F on our keyboard to bring up our mask feathering options, and let's drag this up till we get a nice faded gradient. Now if these borders of the mask are too close to the edge, you're going to see the layer underneath creep in. So let's give that a white berth by pulling these out a touch. Now to get this animating, we're going to add a turbulent displace effect. And we're going to find our evolution property here, hold Alt or Option on our keyboard and click to bring up our expression window. And we're just going to type in time times 200. And that will just increase the value of that property. So now we've got it continuously animating. Now we can adjust our amount and size here to create the look that we're after. The size of 350 works well, I think, here. And we can also change this expression to time times 100, which will just make it animate a little slower. There we are, that's kind of a bit nicer and more gradual. To add another color, I'm going to duplicate this layer with Control D and eyedrop our pink color. And then I'm going to select our pen tool, and then I'm just going to move our mask. There we are. You might not be able to tell so clearly here, but the turbulent displace will be warping both of these layers in the same exact way. So to get a bit of variation between them, we just need to go into our evolution options and choose a different random seed. As long as it's different from the other one, it'll be fine. And now there's a bit more variance between them. They overlap a bit more in some parts, so it's a bit more random. And then we continue duplicating these layers, adjusting the masks, and changing the color. It's helpful to pick colors that are going to blend well nicely. If we've got a green going into a pink, that will probably create a bit of, you know, muddiness and a brown in between the layers, which is, you know, if you want that, that's great. But to avoid this kind of muddiness, best to stick to colors next to each other on the color wheel. You could also add the effect gradient ramp to any one of these layers and move the start and end of the ramp. So now you've got a gradient within your gradient. And after we've duplicated those layers and adjusted the masks a few times, we end up with this. This is all on a composition called Gradient Wand. Let's go back into our main comp and see how we're going to use this. We've got this comp as a background here, and I'm going to make this palette a guide layer as well, just so that it doesn't show up in our main comp. Back in our main comp, I've got this Gradient Wand layer as a background here. I've also got a duplicate of that background layer here, which I've duplicated and flipped vertically. And I'm going to use that as an alpha mat for this shape here, which just covers the bottom half of the composition. So I'm going to set that to alpha mat, and then I've also added a wave warp effect to that shape layer. So now we get a nice wave happening throughout the middle of our comp. And this bottom section is serving kind of like a reflection in the water of this gradient sky. And then to create a border, I've got a shape layer, which is just a square that I've, you know, scaled down a bit further from the total size and width of the comp. And then I've got another copy of our gradient comp here that I've rotated 180 degrees. And I'm going to use that frame mat as an alpha mat, and I want to choose alpha mat inverted. So now we've got a nice frame around the whole thing and two gradient sections. So now with just one comp and a couple of mats, we've got this sort of gradient effect going on. Now I'm going to show you how to add gradient shading to this character here. I've got him in a separate comp where there's no animation, and we've got his body, his mouth, and his eyes, pupils, and the whites of his eyes on separate layers. I'm going to duplicate his body comp, add a fill effect to that, and select our pink from our palette over here. Let's rename that body shading. And now with our pen tool selected, making Tool Creates Mask is selected, I'm going to draw a mask on the bottom right hand side of him, where his shadow would be. And let's feather that as well. There we are, already starting to look alright. Now let's draw another mask to make the shadow for one of the eyes. Let's make sure we feather that one, that looks a bit scary. There we are, and let's tuck that underneath. We don't need that to be too severe, we just want a subtle shading under here. Now this mask that we've just drawn, I'm going to make sure that it's selected down here in our timeline, and I'm going to duplicate that with Control D. It's important to make sure that the mask is selected and not the layer, because if you do that while the layer is selected, you're just going to create lots and lots of layers. Often I'll be trying to duplicate a layer and I'll be pounding Control D like a madman, thinking, where on earth is this layer that I've summoned? But I've had the mask or a shape selected, and then now somehow I've got 400 duplicate shapes or masks inside that layer. So check what you've got selected if pressing Control D and duplicating isn't acting how you'd think. So now we've duplicated our masks. We can see here down here in the timeline, we've got 3 in total, but we can still only see 2 masks in the composition window because it's duplicated and sitting exactly on top of that other mask. So if I double click it, it will select all the points of that mask. And now we can drag it over to our other eye. I'm also going to add one more mask to create some rim lighting on the bottom right here. So I'm going to draw this one very close to the edge. Now at the moment, nothing appears to have happened. That's because we need to change this mask to subtract rather than add. And then it will cut out this shading layer and reveal the yellow layer underneath. Let's add some feathering to that layer. And let's make that one really small, maybe only 12 pixels. There we are. I've also added a highlight layer, which is filled white, acting on the top left here using the exact same method. And I've also added some shading to the eyes as well. Because both of the pupils were on the same layer, I've managed to shade them both just using one mask. A real pro move there. If you ever see a mask drawn like this all over the place, you know that that animator is the real deal. It's the equivalent of carrying all the groceries to the house in one trip. Back in our main comp, I've got a few effects on an adjustment layer that I've put on top of everything. I've got a post-rise time set to 12.5 frames per second because I love that 12 frames per second look, and I've also added a noise effect as well. This is because you can get some pretty nasty banding effects if you're using gradual gradients and it's compressing a lot. So adding noise and increasing the color depth of your project as well over here are the best ways to avoid that. If you're in 8 bits per channel, maybe go up to 16 or maybe 32 if you're feeling really adventurous. I've also made a bunch of experiments that were made just using that gradient comp, layering it, and then using a bunch of effects to animate it in some different unexpected ways. I'll be going through all of those in a separate video coming out next week.
I've made a short playlist of some related videos that I think you'll enjoy if you've made it this far. I'll see you in the next video, and please consider subscribing if you'd like more of these videos every week.